role model to his two beautiful sons. Ladies and gentlemen, all of you love him. We all love him. He is the brand ambassador of Gillette India and the man who exemplifies the values of inner steel. Please welcome Rahul Dravid. Always, always a pleasure to meet you.
Lovely to see you.
He is a thorough gentleman, exemplifies inner steel values. He is, actually there's no better fit for Gillette than a man like him. So we'd like to know, to begin with, your thoughts on this initiative.
I think it's a fantastic initiative. I think all of us have that memory. I think, you know, every one of us have that memory of growing up and watching our fathers shave and you know, sort of sneaking in and watching him shave every day, and especially me and my brother, you know, just watching my father shave every day. And just sort of wondering when would we grow up and, you know, when would we get the chance to shave? And then almost seemed like a sort of rite of passage that, you know, you sort of, I'm a grown-up man now, I can actually use my father's razor and shave. And he always used his razor. So I think it's a fantastic initiative because it recognizes that relationship, it recognizes that bond, it recognizes so many things, you know, about a father-son relationship.
Our relationship with your father, we have on previous occasions as well, but Father's Day has just gone by, and what did your sons do for you on Father's Day? What did they do for their dad? What kind of relationship do you have with your two beautiful sons?
It's a fantastic relationship. I'm learning a lot about, you suddenly feel a lot more responsible about everything you do. I think, you know, you suddenly realize that your children are watching you, and your two sons are watching everything you do and everything you say, even a small thing like driving the car and you know, whether you stop at a red light and what things that you do. They watch all your actions, and I think that's something that I've learned from my father, that, you know, you sort of watch so much. And he was not about giving big speeches or big lectures. My father was never one for that. But he was someone who I think I could learn a lot from, just following what he did and the way he led his life and the simplicity with which he led his life, I think was a great lesson for me. So it's just something that I'm conscious of as now as a father myself, that my children are growing up and they're watching everything that I do.
You've been a role model for so many young boys and men even before you became a father. So was that transition easy when I'm a dad? Well, you know, I've been a role model for lots of young boys and
I think when you're in a public space and you're playing, it's a lot more a controlled environment. So you're in control of whatever you're saying and doing a lot more than you are at home. So I think it's a lot more tougher at home. And I think, you know, your children challenge you as well. You know, they will push back and they will challenge you and they will say, you know, why? And my elder son is growing old enough to now question and ask questions. So it is a lot more difficult and it is a lot more challenging, but also, you know, hugely enjoyable and great fun.
Always had a very close and warm and a wonderful relationship with your father. What kind of a role model was he to you?
Look, I think just from, from a cricketing perspective, my father was a huge role model because, you know, my earliest memories are actually of him, you know, we had a black transistor radio at home and of him actually listening to commentary, you know, whether it was, you know, India playing in the West Indies and listening to Gavaskar score 100 or India playing in England. In those days, you know, my dad would tune on to the radio and he would listen to the commentary and you know, just I would sit with him and listen to him and he would tell me stories. And, you know, Sunil Gavaskar was his sort of big, he was a big fan of Sunil Gavaskar. So he would tell me stories about Gavaskar and what Gavaskar did in 71 and, you know, how he's grown up. So I think even from those young days, just that inspiration and the passion for the game is something that, you know, I imbibed from him and learned from him. I mean, even when he had leave and, you know, he had a weekend off, and if there was even a Ranji Trophy match in Karnataka, my dad would take me to watch Vishwanath and Brijesh Patel play or Chandrasekhar bowl or Prasanna bowl. So I have memories of way back as a 5-6-year-old kid going to the KSCA stadium to watch Ranji Trophy matches. So I think I owe a huge debt in that sense to him in terms of just, you know, giving me the love and a passion for the game, you know, and I think that's something that sort of came through.
What a lineup, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to give you 2 seconds to take pictures. What a fantastic lineup of people we have here. Arbaaz, first up. Acha, pehle aapko picture lena hai, par picture ke bahut mauke milne wale hain.
Definitely. To answer your question, Mandira, my father has been definitely very inspirational and has been a role model for me. I kind of try to emulate him in every possible way and try to, you know, walk along his footsteps. There are so many things that I've imbibed from him and learned from him. And I wish some of the qualities that he has, I have, and I can pass them on to my son.
Important thing is that you have to lead from the front. And you have to set
your spoken like a true cricket fan.
Yeah, and you have to lead from the front, and you have to set an example, a very good example. I mean, the most important thing is that I believe, and I firmly believe, that you cannot possibly love anybody whom you don't respect. You have to, you know, get the respect from the children for you to for them to love you. And then when they love you, you can ask them so many things, and they will, you know, obey all those things. And then commitment is the most important thing. I mean, even I used to take my casual commitments very seriously. One day my son Sohel said, whenever I'm interacting with people, those who have worked with you and all that, they genuinely talk very highly about you. So it is not difficult, you can also do the same thing. But most of the time you say, Daddy, are you at home? I'm coming for a drink. And you don't come, but you don't even inform me that you are not coming. I said that I take my casual commitment also. If I say I'll meet you tomorrow, I'll go and meet him. Whether it is transaction in money, whether it is, you know, a commitment, any kind of a commitment, I take it very seriously. I don't take it casually. Nahin. And I am very punctual. And most important thing is that tell your children not to lie. The first problem starts from lying. And I have also, in that also, I have set an example. So this is very important.
He adapts to it, like, you know, more often than not, there'll be nobody there to appreciate it, you know. But still, you still have to be on time, because that's something that I'd really learned from him. Even if I have to go out for, like he said, for very casual commitments, I tend to be on time.
Yeah, he was about 8 years old, so he was interested in cricket and he was interested in singing also. So yeah, I was. So I took him to Khal Gymkhana, and I've got I used to have a lot of friends there, and I introduced them, and I wanted him to be a cricketer. And after a few days practice, and we have kept a singing master also, music master, and he was learning to sing also. One day I was sitting with my drink, and he came and said, Daddy, what do you think I should take up as a career? I said, singing or cricket? I said, you should take up cricket. I said, have you seen me batting? I said, no, I have heard you singing.
Nice one.
Good evening to everyone. So when I started even going to school, everything has been first with my dad, because I was the only kid in the family, and more than my mom was a working lady. My dad was with the government, was a government employee. So he was able to spare everything for me, in the sense he used to take me to school, used to drop me at school, pick me up back, take me to cricket classes. I mean, including matches, he used to stand right in front of the side screen and watch the game right from the start to the end. So his commitment towards his son, more than making me into anybody, like a cricketer or a student or an engineer or whatever it is, he was very, very particular that I was brought up in the right fashion, with the right values. Like he was just saying, he could never accept me lying. Even if I was, we had a lot of firsts for his saying. I love to play alongside him in the terrace and on the streets. So he was very, very encouraging of the fact that I could hit the ball. Even if I brought down the neighbor's windows, he was okay with it. He used to go and actually fight with them and say, okay, I'll pay it up. You don't have to shout at my son. So he's a very good dad in terms of giving me freedom. And also he meant that if I'd made any mistakes, he would definitely tell me, he would encourage me to come and tell him the truth, rather than actually say, no, I didn't do this and do that. So he was in those ways, he was very, very good bringing me up ethically right and very disciplined as well.
Well, not a very easy question to answer, because I don't know whether there's any one single aspect that he has, that I've learned from him, that would probably be the most important thing. There are so many elements and so many layers to what he has taught us in life, which if one has to follow, I think there's the, you know, like honesty is one of them for sure. Honesty, discipline, hard work, they'd all probably be in the same commitment, and being loyal. Yeah, I think these are the things that I feel are very, very high on his list, and there are far more, many of them. I think most of the things that define a good human being, I think he gives it a lot of priority, and he expects a lot of that to be followed by his kids. And actually, not out of any force, more like of him being a role model and seeing it happen and seeing the benefits of that. Because he genuinely believes that, you know, sometimes there are quick roads to certain things, but the take the longer route, it'll probably be the happier way to go. So that's something that there's not a quick fix to anything. He believes in that, and I think that's what we've learned from that. Work hard, and even if it takes time, it'll happen, but don't lose sight of what you want to do.
No, I would never interfere with, in their lives, because they are grown up now, they understand everything, and you know, children are as much part of nature as you have to protect them while it is a small tree, is that you have to cover it up and all that. But once they grow up, you just have to leave them alone, as you cannot plan the growth of a tree, it grows on its own. But only thing is that when I see something wrong, then I will tell them. When I see registered something, that is the only thing. I have never interfered with their personal life, with their emotional life, and with their married life. I have allowed them. I have never put them while growing up into any pressure, okay, you have to do like this, or you have to come first, or you have to play cricket like this and all that. I believe that jo inki taqdeer mein hai, jo inki destiny mein hai, wo hoga.
When I made the transition from being an actor, you know, to doing something else, if it meant producing a film or directing, I think that was a call I had to take, because it's very difficult to turn around and say that, you know, I didn't make it that successful as an actor, and I think it's about time that I think about something else. So that time I came to my father and asked him, you know, I said, you know, I don't think my career as an actor is heading anywhere. There's a standard that I want to achieve in my life, and I don't think it's happening in the field that I initially chose. So he asked me, what do you want to do? So I said that anything apart from you know, acting, because I think I've come to a point where I'm stagnating. I don't think there's going to be a breakthrough and it's going to transform my career. It's like anything, you know, you give every, like even for in test cricket, you get maybe 1, 2, 3 test matches or whatever to prove your mettle, and after that you can just be playing cricket and may never get a chance again. So it depends on what you're made of, whether you want to. I didn't have the kind of courage to go ahead. Then I told him, I said, you know, maybe something in the same field, because I love the film world too much, I love cinema too much. I want to do something over here, even if it means producing a film and or directing a film. I've had the years of experience. So he says, keep your eyes open. If something excites you, you want to do it, I think that's what you want to do. So I think that was a trying period in my life, because that, if you wanted one example of what happened in my life, and that was quite a turning point, because that decision, I had to take that call. Had I kind of pushed and pursued with what I wanted to do, maybe I would have been also ran, and I at least could make a mark now. And now I know which direction I think I should be heading mainly. Not that, you know, if there are any producers and directors around, that I am not open for any acting roles. I still am, but I'm not concentrating on that anymore.
I started my first shave when I came to Bombay at the age of 23. I never used to regularly shave, but I started shaving regularly when I came to Bombay. And these people, my children, have done everything, every possible thing what I have done. So after that, so you know, growing up, like they wanted to play cricket, like okay, they were all shaving also. And they used to, you know, bring their girlfriends also at home.
No, don't stop him. Don't stop him.
Girlfriend also at home. So my wife objected to it. My wife objected to it. कि क्या है बच्चे हैं अभी छोटे छोटे हैं. This is a very young project, and this is what they are doing. I said, you will tell them not to bring them home. They'll go on the rocks on the seafront. So it is better that they come in front of you. So these are the things they started, and one of them was shaving. So they also started at the right age.
Say the three things that he taught us: one was how to ride a cycle, yeah, two, the love for cinema, and three, the love for drinks.
last thing I taught them is how to drink. That was the last.
I recollect, you know, Dad used to use those single blades, the Gillette ones, which you got to screw,
yes,
up, you know, which was, yes, pretty fancy at that time. And as kids, we're always fascinated by the fact that when we're going to shave, how we're going to do it, because it's not as if the first time you ever thought you're going to do it. Then I think I took Dad's permission, and that's how I think I shaved. I used his razor, I remember.
He
told me he would use my razor but change the blade.
Good, very hygienic.
8 varsh ki umar tak to inke baad shave kara tha humne. It is a turning point.
But you know, strangely, you want to do the transition from boyhood to manhood
But when you actually shave, you look 4 years younger. You look like a kid, and you're like, why did I shave, you know, for that matter? Because the first dialogue that comes from people is that, "Arey, tu bacha lag raha hai yaar, ya chikna lag raha hai," and both you don't want to hear.